So let's first create a lower third theme that we're going to use. So heading back to the computer, if we click on the little ellipsis right here where it says more and go down, we can select theme editor. Now once we get here, I've already got one here, but let me show you how to make one. So to make a brand new theme from scratch, we can click on this little drop down and go to new theme. And so let me call it. Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to do lower thirds on a secondary screen. Hi and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've been trying to figure out just piecing together from various tutorials, and I admit I do a lot of them, how to do lower thirds on a secondary screen, but full screen on a primary one, go ahead. Tell me about it below. Like, subscribe, and stuff like that. Even share it with some people if you find this helpful. So this is one of the questions I get the most. As I'm traveling around doing these in-person classes, by the way, TDM.fyi/events24 is the list of events in 2024 as I'm recording this. It'll probably be events 25 next year. As I'm doing these events, one of the most common questions I get is, I know how to do lyrics, but how do I change the position of the words that are on screen to a lower third for a secondary screen, like that I'm going to send to a live stream? Well, let's head over to the computer and we'll take a look at exactly how we would do that. So we start off, and first off, we need an alternate theme. Now, there we go. A theme is like a template. So, or maybe even a better way to describe a theme is thinking of it as a stencil. So you're probably familiar of a stencil being a cutout that you put somewhere and then you paint over, and then when you remove it, it only shows part of what you had painted. There's a thing going around TikTok and some of the other kind of short form video sites where someone will have several stencils and you won't know what they're painting until towards the end, because they'll paint one color, put up another stencil, paint another color, take off the second stencil, put up a third, etc. And at the end you have, I don't know, Iron Man or Harry Potter or whatever. So think of a theme kind of like that. Now, when they get done with the theme, with the stencil rather, they can throw that away and it doesn't affect the image that they've already painted. Well, in ProPresenter, it's kind of like that, except when you're using a theme on the fly for a secondary screen. So let's first create a lower third theme that we're going to use. So heading back to the computer, if we click on the little ellipsis right here where it says more and go down, we can select theme editor. Now once we get here, I've already got one here, but let me show you how to make one. So to make a brand new theme from scratch, we can click on this little drop down and go to new theme. And so let me call this worship lower third and click save here. Okay, and so it creates something that looks like a slide, only the difference is any text that I type in here is just example text. It's not going to actually paste the words themselves, just how they look when you apply that theme. So let me put my mouse over these little drag handles and I'll drag it down to about the bottom third of the screen. And Let's say that I think that that text is actually a little small, so I double click on it, and then in the text tab here at the top, I can make it a little bit bigger. So maybe like that. Personally, I like either putting a color behind the text so that it helps it pop in case we've got white text on a overlaying on top of someone with a white shirt or white dress or whatever, choir, if you've got white choir robes, things like that. So one of those two is the way to go. Let's do it this way. I'm going to go to shape here and select fill and change this to black. So now if let's just type in some gibberish here. And then I'm going to hit the enter and type in some more just so that we get a feeling of what this looks like. It wants me to do some gibberish that I've done before. But anyway, so we've got that. So that's good. I'm going to click it. And now I'm going to go to text and select lines only. And oops, clicked outside of it. It got confused. So lines only. And now I'm going to just tweak with padding so that it separates those lines just a bit. Went a little overboard. But that should separate that text from the background. Again, as I say, if I had white letters on top of a white background, that could cause problems, but now I should be good. Even if the black blends in, the fact that the white is on top of the black, that would be fine here. And I could do that in the opposite way if I wanted to. But all that to say, there we are with it set like that. And now I can go back to show mode and let me just select a song here. So, oh, this has already been done. So let me right click. Actually, I'm going to select all. I'm using Command A on my Mac. Control A on Windows will do the exact same thing. And I'm going to right click and apply a full. Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got a either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to tdm.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. A full screen theme, if I've got one. Yeah, this will work. So, do this real quick. Okay, and you can see how this is full screen. It's still got a translucent background behind it, but that gives you just an idea of what's going on. So that's this song, Alabaster Heart. If I click on one of the slides, my ProPresenter is going a little slow, probably because of all the props and stuff that I've got in it. I need to clean this out just a bit. But anyway, all that to say, so here we are, And that's the way that it looks on my regular audience screen. Let's use my alpha screen for my lower third. So right now, got it, and it's got this set up as the lower third. So how did I do that? If we click on looks up here and go down to edit looks, you'll notice that I have right here an alternate theme. So let me just click remove alternate theme just to show you that by default with this Ghostbusters symbol here, or the null set symbol, then it looks the same because it's not doing anything different to it. When I click on it and then select, let's say, the worship lower third theme that I just created, and I save that, it applies it right here. So that is how I can, on the fly, apply that theme to one of my other outputs here. So that works fine. Now, how am I going to get that out? Well, it depends. If I'm sending it to other software on a different computer, I might want to use an NDI screen. So I can create one up here under screens, configure screens, and I can just add an audience screen here. Right now I've got the alpha one that I was showing you, but there's no reason why I couldn't click here and select one for NDI, and that would send that over the computer network to another computer. Maybe that other computer is running some live streaming software like OBS, Open Broadcaster Software. That would be something that I could do. There's other pieces of software that do the same thing. So I could send it over there that way. If I have the live streaming software on my same computer and it's a Mac, I could send that as a siphon screen, and that will send that with transparency over to other software on my same Mac. So that's another way I could do it. It could be that I have a video switcher, and if I have a video switcher, the best way to do it is how I'm doing it with alpha here, where I set this up as a straight key with an external key, and I send this. This is coming out of my DeckLink Duo. I've got lessons on all of these. Another way to do it, though, is if my video switcher cannot support alpha or I only have one video input, I could change the screen background color to green and then use the chroma key feature inside of the switcher to remove that green background and then overlay that over top. So I've got plenty of options of ways to do that inside ProPresenter. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/proquick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from trinitydigitalmedia.com and churchtechu.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.